Welcome back to CAD/CAM tutorial. Today we are going to create this simple flange bolt in SolidWorks, and we will learn some basic features, how to use thread tool to create this thread, and some basic features like extruded boss base, extruded cut, revolve boss base. So let's see how to make this simple bolt in SolidWorks. Let's start to create a bolt here, flange bolt here. If you will saw here, see here 18 millimeter is the width of this bolt head, and how long we need to extrude 10 millimeter. Then this rod length is 45 millimeter and the diameter here is 12 millimeter. So let's do this first, and at the end you will find here chamfer 1 millimeter 45 degree. And here at corner you will see 0.5 radius. Now I'll choose here, let's say top plane. Okay, let's go for front plane sketch, and I'll choose here polygon, and here keep parameter 6 number inscribed circle. I'll click here, I'll keep pointed top side, right click, select. I'll choose this one vertical. Now let's define the smart dimension, and that is 18 millimeter. See, this is fully defined sketch. Exit and go to feature and choose extruded boss base. Keep end condition blind, and the length we need to extrude 10 millimeter. Say okay. Okay, let's select the back surface sketch circle, and here we need to create a rod with 12 millimeter diameter. Okay, see, this is fully defined. If the black color shows fully defined sketch, now go to feature and choose extruded boss base, and here end condition keep blind and make the length 45 millimeter. See, okay. Now if I'm going to put here a chamfer, I'll click the edge and you'll see two options, fillet and chamfer. Chamfer here, first option, angle distance we will keep. Item to chamfer, we already selected edge. See, arrow going down, because even though you can change flip, but in this condition we need to keep direction down. 1 millimeter 45 degree, say yes. Look, in the same way, I'll choose this inside edge, and here one option, fillet. Constant size fillet, item to edge selected, and this one keep as it is. Full preview means it will give you a preview. 0.5 radius, you will see the preview here. Say okay, that's it. Now let's create here. Okay, let's make cutout here. You will see this R2 radius. So we need to use some cutout tool to create this corner radius R2. Then there is inside one hole, 15.75, and the depth is 2 millimeter. And inside radius also 2 millimeter. So let's try this. I'm going to choose right plane, because right plane covers this corner sketch, and I'll choose here 3-point arc, connect from here to here. Okay, I'll connect line. Now do one thing, select these two lines, equal relation, and this radius 2 millimeter. Okay, now let me do one more thing, these two points. Now see, this is fully defined sketch. Even though if you directly click the dimension, this one you will get same. Now let's use center line, create a line, because we want to use this line. Now I'll show you here, go to feature, exit, and here choose revolve cut. See, line of axis, this is the construction line we selected, end condition blind, angle 360, we want to cut throughout this circle. Say yes. See, the radius is created. A sketch. Here the circle is 15.75 millimeter exit, and extruded cut and choose extruded cut feature, and the depth, keep end condition blind, depth only 2 millimeter. If I select inside edge, fillet, and that is 2 millimeter, see, constant size fillet, look. Now let's define this dome or this flange actually. Flange distance 5 millimeter. If let's see here, 5 millimeter from here, the outer length, you will see the outer length is 26 millimeter diameter. And if you saw corner, there is a fillet 0.9 radius, but distance from this center point 0.5, sorry, not 9.5. And this width also 0.5. So let's try this. For creating dome shape, either use let's say top plane. I'll select here line. Start from here to here. Connect. Go back to the point and see, it's going to convert into arc, but it is not looks what we like. So here keep, let me do one thing, connect line, exit, and here I'll choose tangent arc. I'll select arc from here to this point. Now at this point, this is tangent to this. (26/2.5), and this length is 5. Now see, this is fully defined sketch, circle, and let's draw here a circle. And that is 0.5 millimeter. This is also fully defined. Just simply select this one, construction line. Okay, this is full geometry. So let's try here revolve boss base. Now here the line, let me choose this, and in selected contour we have two bodies, one, and uncheck thin feature. Now you will see the preview. Say okay. Now look. Now let's do one thing, let's apply material. Appearance. Let's say steel nickel. Okay. Now here you will see 12 into 1.5 machine thread. So we will apply here, either we can apply cosmetic thread or real thread. So we will apply real thread. And the thread length is 30 millimeter. See here. Just click here thread, drop down the menu of whole wizard thread. Okay. Now first option, you need to choose age of cylinder. So I'll choose this edge. Now see, now comes down, keep this one as it is, end condition blind, length we want to keep 30 millimeter. Okay, now here type, we want to create a type dia, inside cut dia. See here, cut thread, this is the option we need to choose. Because if you will choose here, tap, see thread will comes up. It comes upside. So we need to create die. By default 12 millimeter 0.25, okay. Here we need to choose the M12 into 1.25. See, cut thread. We don't need these options because now left or right, so we will keep right. Now here in preview also you will see the shadow preview. Now this is the shadow preview, this is wireframe. If you increase wireframe, you will see too many wires, see. So let's keep 0 or even partial view. In partial view, you will see only line. So let's keep frame view. Now, I'll say yes. If I'll say yes, see, there is a steps. See. So edit, we will use here offset. Let's keep 5 millimeter offset, it is going inside, so let's say outside, and here comes down and click maintain thread length so that it maintains 30 millimeter from this end to here. Look, so this is the simple tutorial how to create a flange bolt in SolidWorks. I hope you like it. Don't forget to share and like our video, and please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks. Thanks for watching.